space maybe something all the time. Because remember, I told you, empty space is full of these things popping in and out of existence at times that are so short we can't see them. But once you add gravity into the mix, and gravity can allow negative energy as well as positive energy, you create stuff whose total energy is zero. And once you start creating stuff whose total energy is zero, you create as much as you want. And so the laws of quantum mechanics tell us that nothing is unstable. If you wait for long enough for the universe to avoid anything, you will end up with a universe full of something. You don't need God or anything else. It's not magic. It's automatic. You are guaranteed to have a universe full of something if you start out with nothing. Now, that should be enough. Zathal showed me that the nothing of ancient philosophers and theologians will create something. But of course, the minute I say that something can come from nothing, the philosophers and theologians say, well, that can't be nothing. Because we said nothing can't create something, and you just show us you could, so it has to be something else. As I say, read the New York Times today, and you'll see about that. But it turns out it's even better than that. Because when you apply quantum mechanics to gravity, gravity is a theory of space and time, and space itself becomes a quantum object. And not only can you create particles within space, but in fact, you can create space itself. And in fact, once you have quantum mechanics and gravity, you can create whole universes that weren't there before. So the second kind of nothing tells us that the minute you make gravity a quantum mechanical object, you can have no space, and suddenly create space. But what's the only kind of space that you can create that can last forever? Or last long enough that we can ask the question, why is there something rather than nothing in it? It's the universe with zero total energy. Now you may think, hey, you just showed us that only a flat universe with zero total energy and everything works. It's more subtle. I wish I could say that, but I can't. It's just a little more subtle. It turns out we can't calculate the total energy of a flat universe. The gravitational energy of a flat universe is zero, but there's all sorts of other kinds of energy. Rest mass and all sorts of other stuff. It turns out the only universe whose total energy we can calculate is the closed universe. And it has zero total energy. But you may say, hold on, we don't live in a closed universe. Well, it turns out we can ask ourselves, what's the only kind of closed universe that we live long enough for us to live in, to evolve in? And it turns out, it's a closed universe that looks like a flat universe. Because most closed universes that we create will collapse on a timescale a fraction of a microsecond long. The only kind of closed universe that we create that will survive long enough for people to evolve in is one that blows up at very early times, has lots of energy and empty space. The laws of particle physics that we now understand tell us that we believe that's precisely what happened in the early history of our universe. But when you blow up a closed universe, it's like blowing up a balloon. If you blow up very large, then it goes flat. And the only closed universe that can survive 10, 13 billion years is one that has this period of rapid expansion in early times, which we predict in particle physics. And then it must go exactly flat. So this next slide basically just says that. That the only closed universe that can survive long enough for us to measure it is one that goes flat. And therefore, the only universe that can come from nothing, in which intelligent life can evolve, is one that looks identical to the universe we live in. So now we've shown that empty space can create something. We've shown that if you don't have any space, you can create space. So that should be enough. But people then say, well, that's okay. Particles in our